started riding at about, when I was about 12 years old. Yeah, I started riding when I was 12 years old. I rode once a week at Cocoa Crater. And, well, at the first 6 months were really, I didn't really ride much because it seemed to always rain on Saturday. That's when my lessons were. And so I didn't really ride much for the first 6 months. And then finally I got a horse to share board, which means I can, it's not mine, but I can ride it like twice a week. And so then that's when I started getting into it. And I swear this horse took off with me every day. But it was fun. And then I was looking for a horse to buy, and my trainer and my mom, they found this horse. Well, actually I was there. But they got it for me as a surprise for Christmas time. And then last summer I went to Germany. So I got a little bit, I went there for 2 months, and I was like, it was like a crash course in riding. It was like intensive training. And I learned a lot there. And after that, I came back and I went in a show jumping. And I got a, he did really well in that show. And so after Germany, everything's been coming a lot better. So I think I needed to get away a little while and really get a lot of horses to ride. The only thing a show is showing off everything that you've been doing lately. Like everything that you've learned, everything you've been working up to. It's not like a show is something new, because like I've been working for this for a long time, and it's time for me to show off what I've learned. It's not a time for me to show him anything new. It's time for me to really show off the horse. And so, you know, I think about when I go in there is how I can make the horse dazzle, how I can make his normal movement be a little bit better, be just that little edge better than all the other horses that are there. How I, you know, make everything accurate so that they can't take points off for a movement or something. When I'm off the horse, it's kind of relax, you're just kind of waiting for something to happen. And it's nerve-wracking sometimes because you're waiting for to get on. Because once you're on, everything seems to relax because then you have to start really concentrating on what's happening. But when you're off, you're really anxious. It's a real anxious feeling that you're waiting for something to happen and you have to get on and start practicing and making whatever movement look good. And so, I don't know, you're really uptight, and then I start getting snappy at people. Like, I just want them to leave me alone and let me watch everybody else to see what I have to do. I used to run cross country, and I'd be running track now if I didn't ride horses. But I think it's more personal because there's a relationship. It's not just for you. You're not just doing a sport for yourself. And it's not for a team either. It's just, there's just two people. You have, I mean, horse person. It's a team. It's like a team, you and your horse. And you want to show off your horse as best as possible. And like, it makes you feel good when you come out from a hard day's work. And you come out to the stables, and no matter how bad your day was, there's always, you know, the horse is there. And he comes up to you and nickers at you when you walk in. And then you turn him loose or something, and he runs around, and he comes back to you and says hi. And it's a really good feeling because a lot of times you're really down. You know, there's always that one thing, oh, I still have my horse. And no matter what, he's always there.